Welcome students, as in the previous class we were discussing about the different phases of Indian National Movement, and this Indian National Movement was divided into three phases, that was moderate phase, extremist phase and the Gandhian phase. As we have discussed in the previous class about the moderate and the extremist phase, how the Indian freedom fighters, they have strived for the development, for throwing off the Britishers from our country India. And apart from that, we have discussed about the Swadeshi movement, which was launched by the extremist phase in the year 1905 to 1920. During that time, political leaders, they were fighting against the repressive measures which was made by the Britishers in order to take the political rights of the Indian society. For that purpose, the extremist phase leaders, they have been started the Swadeshi movement. Home rule movement was organized by the Annie Besant and Bal Gangadhar Tilak in the 1960 in order to provide the self-rule to the Indian society and to get the Indian society recognition into the political activity. As we have discussed in the previous class about the two phases of Indian National Movement, that was moderate phase, extremist phase. In the extremist phase, we have discussed about the Swadeshi movement and the Home Rule movement. Today we are going to discuss about the third phase of Indian National Movement, that was a Gandhian phase. When we are talking about the Gandhiji, he was a great freedom fighter who has sacrificed his life by adopting a satyagraha, adopting the techniques of satyagraha and holding the stick of non-violence in order to achieve the freedom for our country India. Before knowing about the Gandhian phase, which was organized between 1920 to 1947, what was the contribution of the Gandhiji? What strategies were adopted by the Mahatma Gandhi? Before knowing about that, first we know about the Gandhiji. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was an Indian lawyer. He was an anti-colonial nationalist and a political ethics who employed the non-violent resistance to lead the successful campaign for the India's independence for the British rule. That means here the Mahatma Gandhi, he has adopted the non-violent resistance in order to lead the success of India's freedom, that is independence should be given for the India from the British rule, and in turn inspired the movement for the civil rights and the freedom across the world. And apart from that, he also inspired all the activities through the civil rights also were provided by the Mahatma Gandhi. And Mahatma Gandhi played an important role in the Indian National Movement for attaining the independence to our country, India. The next, now in the detail, we are going to discuss about the Gandhian phase, which took place between the 1920 to 1947. When we are talking about the Gandhian phase was the last and the final phase in the Indian National Movement where Gandhiji contributed his contribution in order to attain the freedom from our country, freedom for our country India. And Gandhiji adopted the unit techniques of satyagraha. Satyagraha is nothing but holding the stick of truth, and he has given a great courage and confidence based on the traditional Indian methods of protest. What type of protest? Like doing the hartals, by adopting the non-violence methods, and these methods were taken into consideration by the Mahatma Gandhi. And Mahatma Gandhi adopted the techniques of satyagraha, which has given a great courage to the Indian society. And apart from that, the Mahatma Gandhi also, he has launched the many of the movements against the Britishers, like non-cooperation movement was there, and the SALT, that is a Quit India movement, was organized by the Mahatma Gandhi. And Mahatma Gandhi also the many of the movements against the British, such as non-cooperation, civil disobedience movement and the Quit India movement also were launched by the Mahatma Gandhi. And the Gandhiji also gave the people a call for the people in order to have their contribution into the hartals and the demonstration against the British rule. That was a draconian law which was imposed, which was known as the Rowlatt Act, which was imposed in the year 1919. According to this act, the full powers were given to the police. Without giving any intention, they can arrest to the Indian people. During that time, as we know, sir, the Punjab also was divided into two provincials. This law also was passed by the British government in order to protest not only the different part of the people from our country, India, and apart from that, the Punjab also particularly participated against the Rowlatt Act. And this during that movement and in the protest of this Rowlatt Act, the two prominent leaders, namely Dr. Satyapal and Saifuddin, they were arrested by the Britishers. This news was spread all over our country, India, and in order to protest for that, the thousands of the people in the Punjab, they have been associated near to the Jallianwala Bagh, which was it was located in the Amritsar. Jallianwala Bagh, it is nothing but it is a garden, and it too had three gates were there, and they were associated in order to have the planning how to be against the Rowlatt Act. And this against the Rowlatt Act, they were associated thousands of the people. General Dyer, who was a general of the British company, there he, without giving any intimation intimation to the people, they entered into the Jallianwala Bagh, and they have been killed to the thousands, millions of the peoples into the who were associated against for the Rowlatt Act. This Jallianwala Bagh massacre, it has been the thousands of the people who were killed into this Jallianwala Bagh massacre, it has taken a sparkle in the Indian society. In order to protest for the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, Gandhiji has gave a call for the non-cooperation movement, and this non-cooperation movement against the British government, and this was launched only after the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. This was the starting of Gandhian phase, which took place in the year 1920 to 1947 in order to get the independence to our country, India. How the Gandhiji has adopted a unique methods by holding the Satyagraha and providing the courage and the confidence, which was based on the traditional Indian methods of protest. And apart from that, he has given a great contribution, to our Indian society in order to get the freedom for our country, India. And he also gave many movements against the British, such as non-cooperation movement was there. And this non-cooperation movement was launched after the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, which took place in the Punjab, in the place of Amritsar, where the thousands of the people were brutally killed by the British employees. General Dyer, without giving any intimation to the people who were associated in order to have the planning against the Rowlatt Act, not only the Punjab people were there, apart from that, the many of the people from other states also, they were associated into the Jallianwala Bagh. And this message was articulated as a fire into our Indian society. In order to have the protest only, the Gandhiji has gave a call for the non-cooperation movement. When we are talking about the non-cooperation movement, as it was launched on 5th September 1920 by the Mahatma Gandhi, and this movement was launched by the Mahatma Gandhi between the year 1920 to 1922, in order to protest against the thousands of the people, innocent people killed into the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. And during that time, Indian National Congress, which was presided by Lala Lajpat Rai, he has extended that the non-cooperation movement, that means the Indian National Congress, should participate into the non-cooperation movement. And they have been given some programs. According to this program, they have been divided the two impacts, that is the negative programs and the positive program. First, we'll discuss about the positive program. The first positive program was the use of Swadeshi goods. What is the use of Swadeshi goods? Whatever the goods are produced by the Indian society, it should be used by the Indians only, rather than using the British good. The second, it was rising of 1 crore rupees fund for the implementing the activities of non-cooperation. In order to increase the activities of non-cooperation movement, 1 crore rupees fund has to be provided for the people for the organizing this non-cooperation movement. The next, it was distribution of 20 lakhs charkas for the unemployed youth of Indian society. If the 20 lakhs charkas will be provided to the unemployed, that is surplus to the unemployed youth of our Indian society, so that they can produce their own clothes and they have to get their own employment. Then formulating and implementation of national education plan. A national education plan has to be introduced into the Indian society to educate the last masses of our Indian people. The last, it was setting up the Congress legislature bodies. That means they should not, they have to set up the national Congress, that is the legislative body has to be set up in place of British legislative bodies. That means the legislative body which was organized during the time of Indian National Movement, it was known as British legislative body. In order, in spite of that, it should be replaced as a Congress legislative body has to be replaced. This was the positive programs which was initiated during the period of non-cooperation movement. The first was use of Swadeshi goods, rising of 1 crore rupees in order to have the people to participate into non-cooperation movement. The third was distribution of 20 charkas in order to provide the employment opportunities to the Indian society. The next, it was formulation and implementation of educational plan in the Indian society in order to provide the education to the Indians. The lastly, it was that setting up of Congress legislative bodies in the place of British legislative bodies. This was the positive programs which was introduced by the Lala Lajpat Rai, who was the president of Indian National Congress during the period of time with the cooperation of Mahatma Gandhi. This was the positive program. Next, coming to the negative program. The negative programs includes boycotting of foreign goods. That means using of Swadeshi goods and not using of foreign goods. That is a boycotting of foreign goods. Re-announcing the British title. That means what type of British title has to be re-announced? Whatever the Britishers are employed, it should be employed only, employment should be given only for the Indians rather than the Britishers. Abstaining from the government sponsored meeting, boycotting the British court, that means they should not attend to the British court, boycotting the election to the Legislative Council. If the Legislative Council elections are not to be held, in that sense what will happen? The people are not participating into the judiciary activities. And this resigning from the membership of local bodies. And this all the negative programs were introduced by the non-cooperation movement. That means the non-cooperation movement, which was started on 5th September 1920 by the Mahatma Gandhi in order to provide the self-governance and obtaining the full independence as the Indian National Congress, that is INC, withdrew its support from the British reform, and following the Rowlatt Act of 21st March 1990, which has given the incidents of Jallianwala Bagh massacre, which took place on 14th November 1919. In order to give protest against the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, this non-cooperation movement was organized by the Mahatma Gandhi, and the Congress party, which was headed by the Lala Lajpat Rai also, they have been combined to support to the non-cooperation movement. And this non-cooperation movement was done on the basis of two programs with it. The first was, that is, was the positive programs and the negative program. Understood now, children? And during that time, the Gandhiji also re-announced the title of Kesari Hind, and apart from that, Rabindranath Tagore also, he re-announced the knighthood in order to provide the independence to our country. During that period of time, eminent advocates also were there. The advocates like Motilal Nehru, Rajendra Prasad and others also, they have boycotted the British court. Why? Because already the negative programs which was supported by the non-cooperation movement in order to establish, in order to have the control, that means Indian's administrative structure should be controlled by the Indian society rather than the Britishers. With this cooperation only, they have implemented this negative programs. And during that time, a violent incident was occurred in the village of Chauri Chaura in the Gorakhpur district on February 5th, 1922. During that time, people, they have 123 police personnel, including the police inspector, and apart from that, the three civilians also, they have lost their life. By seeing this incident, Gandhiji, he observed the 5 days fast on this happening, the withdrawal of this movement has come into the end. That means the Gandhiji, after doing the fast for 5 days, he has stopped this non-cooperation movement. This answer according to the according to the point of examination point of view, this answer will come for the 2 marks for the non-cooperation. You have to write about what is the non-cooperation movement. That means non-cooperation is nothing but not cooperating with the British government. And this non-cooperation, it was launched, that was, it was started by the Mahatma Gandhi after the incidents which was occurred into the Jallianwala Bagh. This massacre, he has, after seeing this massacre only, Mahatma Gandhi, he has given a call. He has started, given a call for the non-cooperation movement between 1920 to 1922. And Mahatma Gandhi, along with the Lala Lajpat Rai, who was the president of Indian National Congress, they have started this non-cooperation movement by the 2 programs, that was positive and the negative program. Now that with the end of the incidents, the violent incidents which were occurred into the Chauri Chaura, which was in the Gorakhpur district, which was occurred during the February 5th, 1922. During that time, what happened? The people burnt the 23 personals, that is the police personals, and including the police inspectors also, the 3 civilians also lost their life. By seeing this incidents, Mahatma Gandhi, he absorbed for the 5 days fast, and he has withdrawn the non-cooperation movement. That means the non-cooperation movement has come to the end by the Mahatma Gandhi after doing the 5 days fast during the period of time. That means non-cooperation movement has came into the end. Next, coming to the Simon Commission. Simon Commission, it is a statutory body. Why this commission has came into the existence? In order to have some reforms into the British government. The British government has announced, appointed a statutory commission, and it was headed by the 7 Englishmen, and the chairperson was Sir John Simon. And this for that purpose only, this commission was named as a Simon Commission. And this was a group of 5, that is a 7 Englishmen, including the Sir John Simon, and they want some reforms should be introduced into the Indian society. And this commission, in order to protest against the Simon Commission, the Gandhiji have gave a call for Simon, you go back. That means this commission should not be introduced into the Indian society, which was introduced by the British government. And in order to have the demonstration, in order to boycott this commission only, in the Lahore, the demonstration which was held in order to boycott the Simon Commission, which was led by the Lala Lajpat Rai. During that time, this agitation, the Lala Lajpat Rai has become a victim of a police in lathi charge, and that was resulted that after a week he was died, and the Simon Commission has came into the end. Simon Commission is nothing but it is a statutory body, and that means statutory commission which was started by the British government in order to have some reforms into the Indian society. And the Indian people were not, they doesn't want this commission to be set up into the Indian society. For that purpose, they started demonstrating in order to boycott the Simon Commission from the Indian society. For that purpose, Mahatma Gandhi, he has said that the Simon, you go back. That means Simon Commission should not be introduced into the Indian society. With the end of this protest, which was started in the Lahore, the boycott demonstration were led by the Lala Lajpat Rai, and he became as a victim of the police in the lathi charge. After a week, he has lost his life. Next, coming to the another movement, which was known as a civil disobedience movement. Coming to the civil disobedience movement, it is a landmark in the constitutional history of our country, India, and it was launched by the Indian National Congress in order to achieve the independence to our country, India. Civil disobedience movement, during that time, Indian National Congress was headed by the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. He has given the ultimatum to the British government to give the independence to our country, India. And he also appealed to the people that to observe the 26 January 1930 as a complete independence to our country, India. That means they doesn't want any Britishers to be introduced into our Indian society. They should be thrown out from our country, India. With this one initiative only, the civil disobedience movement was launched between the period of 1930 and the Indian National Congress, which was during the period of time, which was headed by the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. He has given the ultimatum to the British government to provide, that means to give the independence, complete independence to the India, rather than any concession should not be given. Gandhiji, he also started the civil disobedience movement by taking as assault as a basic law, and along with the Mahatma Gandhi, the 78 staunch followers, they have started doing the demonstration from the Dandi, that was a remote village. They have started from there to Sabarmati Ashram, which took place on 12th March 1930. And this march has taken place between the period of 12th March 1930 to 6th April 1930. And this demonstration, along with the staunch followers, this demonstration was done by the Mahatma Gandhi. And it was popularly known as the Salt Satyagraha. That is the Salt Satyagraha movement, which was launched by the Mahatma Gandhi, and this movement is also known as civil disobedience movement by taking a salt as a law. Salt, as we know, it is a natural resources. No taxation or the price of the salt should not be increased. But what the Britishers did during the period of time, they were imposing the taxes on the salt by taking the salt as a basic law. This civil disobedience movement was launched by the Mahatma Gandhi during the period of 1930. During that agitation, the civil disobedience movement during that time not accepting to the British government, boycotting of foreign goods, using of own goods producing, and using of khadi goods was introduced. By doing this demonstration, by seeing this demonstration, the British government, they have arrested to the Mahatma Gandhi during the period of time. After arresting of this, many of the people in our country started doing hartals, burning of foreign titles. They started doing this demonstration. By seeing this sensitivity, the civil disobedience movement has came, that means it has came to the end by the April 1934 by the Mahatma Gandhi. And civil disobedience movement, it has mobilized the people in a larger way in order to get the freedom from our country, from freedom from the Britishers to our country, India. They saw this movement also actively participated, that means thousands of the peoples also, they participated in the civil disobedience movement. That means civil disobedience movement, it is also known as Salt Satyagraha movement. Why it is known as Salt Satyagraha movement? Because the Gandhiji has taken assault as a basic law. That means it has taken as a basic authority in order to have the freedom from our country, India, which was started during the period of 1930 as a basic law. It was started by the Mahatma Gandhi. The next and the last, it is the Quit India movement. As we have discuss a long struggle which was made by the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, that Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru along with the Mahatma Gandhi, how they have been organized the planning in order to throw out the Britishers from our country, India. Non-cooperation movement was there, and the Simon Commission, against the protest against the Simon Commission, civil disobedience movement was organized during the 1930 period of time. Roundtable conference also were held. The conference is nothing but holding of discussion, a lot of discussion in order to get the independence. That means how the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, he has given the ultimatum to the British government to re-announce, that means to announce the complete independence to the Indian society. To have this part of view only, this roundtable conference were held between the India and the British government. Many of the roundtable conference were held. The last movement which was held in order to get our India, that is the freedom for our country India, that was a Quit India movement in the year 1942. When you are talking about the Quit India movement, marks a significant phase of Indian national movement. During this period of time, the Indian leaders, they were against the repressive measures which was imposed by the Britishers. Gandhiji gave a call that the Quit India movement was launched on August 8, 1947, and Gandhiji gave a call that do or die, that means do for our nation or die for our nation. This slogan was popularized by the Indian National Congress, and they started doing all the Indian society, that means all Indian peoples, they have came into the one platform and they started doing the agitation against the British. The people also continued the agitation in order to protest, in order to get the independence to our country, India, against that also known as the August movement. This movement is also known as August movement. Why? Because it was launched in the month of August and was a movement launched at the Bombay section of the All India Congress Committee by the Mahatma Gandhi on 8th August 1942 during the World War II, demanding to end to the British rule of our country, India. During the time, what had happened, the British, they have been said, if you will, that means Indians will participate into the Second World War, will grant the independence. Now, the situation was so worse that now they need a complete independence without any restrictions should not be imposed into the Indian society. Many leaders like Jawaharlal Nehru, Patel, Maulana Azad, Kriplani, Aruna Asif Ali and the others also during this protest agitation, these leaders were arrested. Quit India movement continued unbanded from the day of Gandhiji's imprisonment in the August 1942 to his date of release in the May 1944. During the time period of this agitation, Mahatma Gandhi along with him, the many political leaders also were arrested by the British government. By seeing this sensation by the British government, they decided to give the complete independence to our country, India. Like this, the Mahatma Gandhi, he has given a contribution to our country, India, in order to have the freedom for our country, India. What was that? The Gandhian phase, it was the last phase of Indian national movement where the Gandhiji has given his contribution along with the Indian National Congress, which was led by the Lala Lajpat Rai. The next, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru also has came into the existence, who has given a lot of cooperation by cooperating by the methods which was adopted by the Mahatma Gandhi. First, he has launched non-cooperation movement. The second, it was a protest against the Simon Commission. The civil disobedient movement, which was launched in the year 1930. The round table conference also were held. That conference is nothing but a meeting venue in order to decide how to get the independence, a complete independence to the Indian society. The last movement which was took place in our country, India, during the period of 1942, that was Quit India movement. That means how quickly the Britishers has to leave our country, India, and they had to grant the independence to our country, India. And during the period of time, Gandhiji, he has given a slogan, do or die. That means we have to do for our nation or you die for our nation. But you have, all the people has to give a contribution to the Indian society for getting the independence. During the Quit India movement, Mahatma Gandhi along with the other leaders also, they were arrested. By seeing this sensation, all the people started doing the agitation. By seeing this sensitive situation, British government decided to give the independence to our country, India. At last, we got independence by the contribution of Mahatma Gandhi. And Mahatma Gandhi's role in our Indian national movement won all over the world. That means it was remarkable in our Indian history how what the contribution was done by the Mahatma Gandhi in order to get the independence in our country, India. That means in this class we have discussed about the Gandhian phase, and apart from that, we have completely the phases of Indian national movement from the starting point of view. We know that there are three phases of Indian national movement, that is a moderate phase, extremist phase and the Gandhian phase. Moderate phase, it was a starting movement of Indian national movement which has been started by the leaders in order to have the concession and the planning, concession should be given to the Indian society. But extremist phase, the new generation leaders, they came into the existence and they have been come with the new ideas in order to have the recognition to the Indian society. Then the last phase, which was organized by the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, who has given his much contribution to get the independence to our country, India. From the examination point of view, children, it is most important answer. This Quit India movement, it comes for the 2 marks. When coming to the civil disobedience movement, it comes, this answer, this topic will come for the 5 marks. And they may ask you to write about the what are the contribution done by the Gandhiji in the Gandhian phase. That means in that way we have to give the introduction about the Gandhian phase, how the Mahatma Gandhi, he has given his contribution and how he has started this phase. The next you have to say about the non-cooperation movement also. You have to write about the Simon Commission, civil disobedience movement. The last you have to write about the Quit India Movement. The next upcoming class, we are going to discuss about the Government of Indian Act. After getting the independence, what type of acts, and before and after, what acts were imposed, what are the main provisions were there, according to these provisions, what type of implementations were done into the Indian society during the period of 1909, 1919 it is there. And we are going to discuss about Indian Independence Act in the year 1947. After getting independence to us, what type of provisions were granted, what type of provisions were given by the British and Indian country.